Hello, welcome to today's Webinar, live from the Melag-Studio here in Berlin. My name is Ralf Hundert and I'm your today's presenter of the webinar, Manufacturer's Recommendation for Routine Operation. So I'm working here at Melag in the product management team and I'm responsible for the sealing devices and packaging materials. Before we start, I would just like to give you a few hints of the Adobe Connect platform which we're using. The big window is where the actual presentation is taking place. On the right side, in the small window, there you can ask questions which we would like answered during the webinar and even after the webinar. And of course, if there are any remaining questions, you can always send us an email, of course. So we start with the agenda. And yeah, the agenda with all the topics we will discuss here today. Then first we will start with a short introduction to introduce the topic. Then we discuss the daily, the weekly, and the annual test methods. As a summary, we have a look on an overview of the test methods, and finally, I will show you where you can find all the information for the routine operations. So we come to the introduction. And yeah, why are routine operations for the packaging process important? The packaging process is an important part between the cleaning and disinfection and sterilization of the instruments. So the main purpose of any packaging system used for instruments to be sterilized is to preserve sterility until use, as well as to all aseptic presentation at the point of use at the patient. To ensure these requirements, we recommend the routine operation for the packaging process. This is intended as a means of ensuring that changes in the packaging process are detected on time before they compromise the steel barrier system and the requirements are no longer met. Furthermore, there are regulatory requirements, for example, the International Packaging Standard ISO 11607 Part 2 give us the specification for the validation of the packaging processes and calls for suitable validated packaging processes, which means, among other measures, the routine operations. So now it should be more clear why we recommend routine controls. And so therefore we start with the daily test, visual checks. Oh, no. And yeah, the visual test is what the assistants do every time when they're sealing packages. Before they start the day, they're sealing operations, they have to make a seal sample as the daily routine test and make the visual test of the sealing process. The seal seam should be distinct and even and should not contain any creases or defects. The seal seam should be almost identical with the work sealing seam, for example, the industrial seal, with an identical color and surface. Is the sealing seam too light? The sealing temperature and or the sealing forces is too low? Yes, this could cause. And if the sealing seam is too brown, the sealing temperature is too high, or the sealing duration was too long. And another point is, according to the standard DIN 868 Part 5, a minimum total seal width of 6 millimeter is required. So if you use a MelaSeal device, MelaSeal 100, 100 plus or 200, there we have a sealing width of 10 millimeters. So all is okay. Yeah. So another daily check is the mechanical check. Yes, it's also a visual inspection. To test the integrity of the pillability of the self-produced seal seams. That is important in order to removing the instruments from the package in an aseptic manner and causing no contamination risk. The seam should be smooth and easy to open. It should be noted on each see-through sterilization package, complying with the standards, is marked with for example, here you see in the right side, the Melafol package is marked with an arrow or so on. Melafol has a blue mark arrow. This is the peeling direction. Yes. So, and yeah, how to perform the peel test? First, we have to cut a package of a length of approximately 200 millimeters. Then you have to seal this package according to your standard working introduction. And after that, you have to place the sealed sterilization packaging in a sterilization cycle. For example, the universal program. This is required. And then, yes, after that, slowly pull apart by hand the sealing seam in the direction of the peeling. So the visual check is now to verify whether the sealing seam extends along the whole width and length. And there are no paper residue greater than 10 millimeters permitted on the sealed seams. So, and last step, you have to document the result. So this is a check for for the quality of the material. So that was the second daily check, and then we come to the weekly test. Yeah, the seal check is recommended for weekly routine testing of the sealing device. The seal check verifies the quality of the seal on the paper via the contrast on the special print. You see the black area. The seal check are helpful to detect major defaults of the heat sealer, major temperature or pressure drifts, and punctual defaults of the seam, for example, deformed by the intrusion of an instrument. The seal check testing system is also used to carry out an operational qualification or performance qualification during the validation process. So, what is needed to prepare the seal check? Firstly, the seal check is to be carried out using a transparent sterilization package with a minimum of 10 centimeter width. The sealing should be carried out in accordance to the standard working instructions in the practice. And the seal check should be used to check the entire sealing width of the sealing device. So if you use a MelaSeal 100 Plus, you have to do two seal checks or carry out two seals a little bit offset. So because the dimension of the seal check is in the width approximately 18 centimeters. So and the width of the sealing device is 100 plus and 200 is 27.5 centimeters. So therefore you have to check first for example, the right side and then the left side. If you use a rotary sealer, then you have to check the scope of the sealing roll only. So, and then the seal check is long enough. So if you have processed the sealing with the seal check, then so during the sealing, the melting of the inner film layer and the pressure of the paper will produce a seal seam along the full length of the surface. So a correct produced sealing seam is uniformly colored and has sharp contours along the full length of the surface. So if we have an insufficient seal temperature, a worn sealing bar, or an insufficient pressure, this becomes visible. According to the Standard 868 Part 5. The seal seam must be 6 millimeters. So you have to check it also again. So on the right side, we see here some failures. The picture A and B. You see on A a defect. Yes, a little bit channel, an open seal, a little bit punctures or tears, and it caused by, for example, a defect pressure rail, or in case the rotary sealer roll is dirty, it will be also an insufficient seal seam. And the same is on picture B. The seal is intact and it's not correct. On picture C, we see delamination or separation from the foil and on the seal check. And it could be a reason because an insufficient contact pressure or temperature is too low. And then we have the delamination effect. Okay, and the last step is documentation of the seal check result. And the documentation and release of the result can be done directly in the documentation field, as you see here on the picture on the right side. And yes, you document the sealing type, for example, Miller Seal 100 Plus, the location, sterilization room, and the signature for approval, the date, and if necessary, remarks. So it's not required to achieve the seal check test stripe. You have only perform to only documentate the performance on the seal check, or it's also possible on a checklist. So I will show you next on later page, later slide, the checklist. So yes, this was the weekly test. And now we come to the annual test. The annual test is the seal seam stability test, and they offer us the most comprehensive and reliable routine examination for the heat sealing process. The seal seam stability test is a standardized test procedure for evaluation of your Melac sealing device. The test is carried out with a state-of-the-art tensile strength testing machine for a guaranteed valid result. The machine you see on the picture, yes, from German manufacturer Zwick. It's a very good machine. And yeah, what does the test check? So first, we testing the combinability of the sealing device in your practice with the transparent sterilization packaging used on site. And this is the performance qualification, approves if the packaging process is reliable and provides consistent results, confirmed to the standards. And yeah, how we do this seal seam stability test. So first I give you an overview with a short step-by-step guide. Firstly, we receive the order for the seal seam stability test. Then we have to prepare the samples here at Melac, performing the test and the evaluation of the test result. And at the end, if the test was successful, we will issue a certificate of conformity. So let's have a look to the individual steps in detail. So firstly, you have to download the order form of the seal seam stability test from the Melac website, for example, on the download center. And there on the section recommendation for sealing devices and packaging. The order form consists of three pages. The first page is a short introduction, what we have to do to prepare the samples, and the second one, second pages, and the third page must be complete and send with the samples to MATLAB. So let's have a look to preparing the samples. So I will give you a short example. The practice use three types of foils, one small foil, 5 centimeter width, and two larger one, 10 and 15 centimeters. So the smallest one, you have to cut three 10 centimeters test stripes from the 5 centimeter foil, which is used in the practice. And from the other larger one, you have to only cut one test stripe, approximately 10 centimeters. All test stripes must have two seal seams separated by a gap of approximately 5 centimeters. Mark all test stripes with a sequence number. So we have here in our example five samples, three of the smallest one and each of the larger one. And then sterilize all test stripes in your steam sterilizer using the universal program, 134 degrees. And yes, after that, complete the order sheet. And send all samples together with the order sheet to MELAG. So then we will receive the order here at MELAG, and we have to prepare the samples. We have to cut each sample for the tensile strength machine. Each sample have to clamp. And then, yes, after that, we can do this the test with each sample. So the processor controlled unit we have allows us to evaluate the seal strength test. Yes, an automatic generation of the certificate with graphic protocols, and this is for each samples. So after the foil test strips have been tested successful, MELAG will issue a certificate. The certificate confirms the conformity of the seal seams with the standard DIN EN 868 Part 5 Appendix D. Please note important hint: the seal strength testing is offered exclusively for the MELAG sealing devices. So we can this test not do for the competitors' devices. So it's only for the MELAG devices. But we can test it all foil types. It must be a see-through sterilization package according to the standard 868 Part 5, regardless of the manufacturer. So we can test all foil types. And the number of the films is unlimited. So the price will be the same in if the practices send us three samples or 10 samples. And the average order processing time is approximately 2 weeks. So this was the seal seam stability test, the yearly routine test operation. And now we come to the overview of the test methods. And yes, the overview is a short summary of all recommended routine tests, and it shows the types of defects which we can detect it here on the left side. So then you see next the seal check, there's the ink test. We don't have discussed this here in the webinar. If you use pushes with fold, the ink test is needed only because the seal check doesn't work because of the fault of the push. So if you have any other type of foils, pushes or reels, the seal shake is okay. Yeah, it's, so this is yeah, one the important information of the overview here page. So now come to the next page to look. Okay. Yeah, I will show you the information about the recommendation for routine operations. Yeah, where you can find the recommendations for routine operations after the webinar as standard, or the information you will find in all operating manual of the sealing device. And yeah, of course, we can download the recommendations for the sealing devices and the packaging materials on the Melag website. Also in the download section, in the yeah, recommendation, and then in this area for the sealing devices and packaging. Here's is marked on the right side of the page with the red mark. So, and then I'm told you before, for the daily visual checks, mechanical visual checks, and the weekly test, we offer you a checklist in which you can quickly and easily document the daily and the weekly routine test. This document is also available on the web page in the download section, and even after the webinar in the yeah, you will see it. Okay. Yeah, and now yeah, we come to the end, but I would like to make you aware of our different options we have online. And yes, of course, we have a webinar section, and there you will find our complete schedule of our future webinars. If you follow the link in the presentation, you will get directly to the webinar page, to the English webinar page. And our next webinar are on the 3rd of October, and the topic is Mela Trays, benefits and workflows and user configuration. And yeah, next tip is Mela YouTube channel. There's also a link on the web page here, you can see. And we always have the latest webinar here on the YouTube channel. We have product videos, tutorials, and even videos from reference practices, where you can see the Melag system, the integrated practice workflow for instrument treatment. So you can watch wherever you are and wherever you want the videos. Finally, the Melag webpage will help you to get a lot of additional information, especially our download center. Here we provide you with our technical documents, user manuals, product data sheets, for example, for Mela Fol or our sterilization package and our recommendation for the devices. So now, I come to the end. I would like to thank you very much for your kind attention. Hopefully, you enjoyed the webinar as much as I do. Last but not least, I like to ask you to give us a feedback of our webinar. What can we improve? What kind of information you might have been missing? We would be pleased if you contact us. Also, on our social media channels, Facebook, Twitter, Google Plus, Instagram, or LinkedIn. And yeah, so thank you and bye bye for until the next webinar.